Our topic for today's class is sheet dress. You can actually read more about sheet dress in our textbook, and I'll be using the croquis book to show you how to draw your sheet dress. And this sheet dress. Now I'll start with the neckline first. You have the sleeve. There's a cap sleeve. I'm drawing over the hair. Yeah. The waist. With the button, yeah. Side of the dress. The dress has a slit in front, a slit in front. Has a slit in front, then I have my details like buttons running all the way down. Go to the next dress. So the sheet dress. Now this is a side view. It's an eye neck. It has a sleeveless inner. Band has a waist at the band. Nice shape, but it's actually a middle-length dress. Has double flowers. Can I call it a layered dress? There's the layered flowers below. Now this is a side view. You have to learn how to use the croquis you have. Now I'm done with the inner. Now here I go to the shoes to draw the heels. Now I'm done with the second look. Now I'll go with the last look, which is the long dress. Flared sleeve. Done with the flared sleeve, I'll go back to the waist. This is a sheet dress. It could be short, it could be long. Thank you. my drawing, I always say something that the first thing you do when you are done with your drawing, you color the skin first. That's the first thing you do. You can see the skin colored from the dress. So you don't run your colors over the skin. To first, the skin color first. I've been wondering why I'm coloring one of my colors over below the flare sleeve, because the fabric is actually see-through. It's a sheer fabric. Sometimes you can run your colors over the hair. That's if you just want to draw out your design and want it to be visible, you just want to draw it out so people can actually see. I want them to understand the design and the detailing at the neck part. That's why I drew over the hair to create my shoulder. Sometimes you trace out the dress in the right color you are using to keep you in check. At the same time, it helps you stay inside the line art so you don't run your colors out of the line art. The back view, that's why I'm doing that in between the legs at the back there. shade properly without leaving white patches. I always emphasize on doing a neat job. Always make sure your work is presentable. It looks neat. Always cover up every white patch. Touch anything very lightly to give that sheer look. Now it's time to do my finishing. Give my finishing touch. I'm using black shoes. I'm trying to color the shoes. I told you always be careful when using the black felt pen. Do not place much pressure on it. You can hold it. I use it to trace out your work. You can also use your fine liner pen. Now I'm trying to bring out all my details. This time it requires full concentration, don't talk. Now this on this off shoulder we have a detail, more of a lace detailing, like it's more like a kimono. Would I call it more like it's open? It has this open sided kind of top, which the sides are open. It's over this off shoulder, the sleeveless dress. Sorry, the sleeveless dress has like another detail. Top towards the upper part, which is more like a lace fabric. So I'm trying to draw out open side. The side is open. I'm creating the lace pattern. can actually see the fabric underneath. You have to be careful when creating the lace detail. It's a sheer fabric, so you can see through the lace. It looks more like French lace. So that's the design. I'll go to the last one, which is to create the detail. Now I'm tracing out my line at first. At the back seam where you have the zip, that's why I'm drawing out the black lines running all the way down. Now I'm done with that. I'm trying to create my details. Now this is like a lace detail. There's a pattern on the lace. Always use a light shade of color for your background. So even when you are using your black to create your lace detail, then you can see the detailing coming out properly. Do not use dark shade for your background. Now you can see the way I created the spiral on the lace. Now here you have the pattern. This is another way of designing your lace. And here you can see the background. And you can see the detail, the lace detail. Now, one thing I always do is the hair. I'll go back to the hair, which I've not done. Always make sure you color the hair properly. Sometimes I leave little white patches that represent the ray of light over the hair. Now I'm done with the sheet dress. Here you can see, I always say that always color your work properly. Make sure your work is neat, well presented, presentable for yourself, for people to see. And even when your clients are looking at your design, they should look neat and well and presentable. So you don't do tacky job. Always take your time whenever you are drawing, doing your drawing. Now here I'm done with the sheet dress designs.